He deserves this. This is for him. This is for him. You stay the same through the ages. Come on. Your love never changes. There may be pain in the night, but joy comes with the morning. Thank you, Lord. And when the oceans rage, I don't have to be afraid, because I know that you love me. Your love never fails. That's it. Never fails. Come on, Pastor. Your love never fails. Mm-hmm. Never fails. The wind is strong and the water's deep, but I'm not alone here in these open seas, 'cause your love never fails. Thank you, Lord. Sorry. Let's go again. The wind is strong and the water's deep, but I'm not alone here in these open seas. Your love never fails. The chasm is far too wide. I never thought I'd reach the other side. Never thought. Your love never fails. Never fails. And you stay the same through the ages. Your love never changes. There may be pain in the night, but joy comes with the morning as the sun rises. And when the oceans rage, I don't have to be afraid, because I know that you love me. And oh, love never fails. Never fails. Your love never fails. Never fails. Never fails. Though things work together for my good, Lord, you make all things work together for my good. Lord, you make all things work together for my good. And you make all things work together for my good. One more time, let's declare it. You make all things work together for my good. You make all things work together for my good. You stay the same. 'Cause you work together for my, as you wish. Lord, you make all things work together for my good. And you stay the same, Lord, you never change. You stay the same through the ages. Your love never changes. There may be pain in the night, but joy comes with the morning. Thank you, Jesus. And when the oceans rage, I don't have to be afraid, because I know that you love me. And your love never fails. Your love never fails. Hallelujah. Your love never fails. never fails. Your love never fails. Thank you, Jesus. Can you worship him? Can you thank him? Just listen to the melody of this song. And with your own words, thank him. Thank you for his amazing love. Your love never fails, never fails, never fails. Your love never fails, never fails, never fails, never, never. Never, never, never fails, never fails, never fails, never fails. Your love never fails. Oh, stay. One more time. And you stay the same through the ages. Your love never changes. There may be pain in the night, but joy comes with the morning. And when the oceans rage, I don't have to be afraid. Because I know that you love me, and your love never fails. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for this unfailing love, for this unfailing love, for this unfailing love, never fails. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thanks for coming up here, guys. Thank you, Lord. We worship you, Father, with all our hearts. We worship you, Father, with all our hearts. We praise your holy name. And we declare your goodness, your faithfulness. Your faithfulness and how much you trust us, how much you have, like, you believe in us, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. You call me out upon the waters, the great unknown, where fear may fail. And there I find you in the mystery, in oceans deep. My faith will stand. So I will call upon your name, Jesus, and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace. For I am yours, and you are mine. Oh, you are mine. 'Cause you were mine. Thank you, Lord. My faith abound in deepest waters. Your sovereign hands will be my guide. Where fear may fail and fear surrounds me, you've never failed and you won't stop now. So I will call upon your name, your beautiful name, and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul in rest in your embrace, for I am yours and you are mine. Oh, you are mine.
Bridge, Spirit.
Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters, wherever you would call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the water, wherever you would call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. And I will call upon your name and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul rests in your embrace, for I am yours and you are mine. Oh, you are mine, 'cause you are mine. Oh, 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 oh. Jesus, you are mine. Lead us, Spirit. Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters, wherever you would call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters, wherever you would call me.
Lead us, Holy Spirit. Take us deeper than you could ever imagine.
And my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior.
Holy Spirit,
Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever you would call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. My Savior, He wants to take us deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper. Tere yon dere ma dere yon darai ere re marai. Take us deeper, Lord. Take us deeper, Lord. We want to know you more. We want to know you more. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your faithfulness. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, lead us. Lead us in faith. Cause you are mine. Oh. Hallelujah.
How are you?
Is it on?
Okay, good.
It is on. Try, tenta de novo.
Hello. Good, good. How are you? Good. I speak English very well, but today, today my sister Clade, is will help me. Yes. Good, good.
He doesn't need me.
Aleluia, aleluia, aleluia. Quero compartilhar algo com vocês nessa manhã.
I would like to share something with you, this morning.
A respeito de honrar ao Senhor.
About honoring the Lord.
Se você puder abrir sua Bíblia comigo em Provérbios, capítulo 1 de Provérbios.
If you can open your Bible with me in the first chapter of Proverbs, Proverbs chapter 1.
Aleluia. Provérbios, capítulo 1.
Proverbs chapter 1.
Vamos ler aqui alguns versículos.
Let us read some of the verses.
Diz assim, do primeiro versículo.
It says that from the first verse.
Provérbios de Salomão, filho de Davi, rei de Israel. Para aprender a viver de maneira inteligente e disciplinada, para entender os ensinos que produzem sabedoria, para desenvolver um caráter correto e perspicaz, vivendo de maneira justa, com equidade e bom senso, para dar prudência aos simples, assim como conhecimento e juízo aos jovens. mesmo o sábio que lhes der ouvidos aumentará em muito seu entendimento, e quem tem discernimento obterá clara orientação para compreender o significado das palavras e parábolas, ditados e enigmas dos sábios.
The Proverbs of Solomon, son of David, king of Israel, for gaining wisdom and instruction, for understanding words of insight, for receiving instruction in prudent behavior, doing what is right and just and fair, for giving prudence to those who are simple, knowledge and discretion to the young. Let the wise listen and add to their learning. And let the discerning get guidance. For understanding proverbs and parables, the saying or and riddles of the wise.
Então nós estamos vendo aqui as palavras de um homem.
So we see here the words of a man.
Que não é uma pessoa qualquer que escreveu esses provérbios.
It's not so and so who wrote these proverbs.
Mas um homem que recebeu sabedoria plena de Deus.
But a man who received the fullness of wisdom of God.
Então é alguém que nós podemos dar ouvidos.
So it's someone that we can listen.
Porque é diferente você ouvir conselho.
Because it's different when we just hear advices.
De alguém que acha que a alguma coisa pode ser feita daquele jeito?
From someone who just think that anything can be done such a way?
Ou você receber conselho de alguém que sabe realmente o que está dizendo?
Or receiving advices from someone who really knows what they're saying.
Isso faz toda a diferença na nossa vida.
This can make such a difference in our lives.
E nós estamos dando ouvidos à palavra de Deus através de um homem sábio.
And we are hearing the word of God through someone who understands, who knows the word of God.
Com a própria sabedoria de Deus.
With the wisdom of God itself.
Então, algumas das coisas que nós vemos em Provérbios.
So, many things we see in Proverbs.
Em meio a tanta sabedoria.
Among such a such an amount of wisdom.
Eu quero que você vá um pouco mais para frente agora no capítulo 3.
I want you to go a little bit forward in chapter 3. Let us jump to chapter 3.
No versículo 9 e no versículo 10, eu quero destacar.
Verse 9 and 10, I want to emphasize.
Um trecho da sabedoria que cabe a nós nesse momento.
A little bit of wisdom that is to us in this moment.
Ele diz assim.
It says that.
Honra ao Senhor com todos os teus bens e com as primícias de todos os teus rendimentos. E se encherão com fartura os teus celeiros, assim como transbordarão de vinho os teus reservatórios.
It says, honor the Lord with your wealth, with the first fruits of all your crops. Then your barns will be filled with to overflowing, and your vats will bring over with a new wine.
Então, um homem que recebeu a sabedoria de Deus.
So, a man who received the wisdom of God.
E foi considerado o homem mais rico.
And was considered the richest man.
Ele tem um conselho simples para nós.
He's got a very simple advice for us.
Mas muito poderoso.
But very powerful.
E esse homem rico, ele diz.
And this rich man says.
Para nós honrarmos ao Senhor com todos os nossos bens.
For us to honor the Lord with all of our possesses, all of our wealth.
E com todos os nossos rendimentos.
And all, with all of our incomes.
Então esse é, a gente vê que é um princípio.
So we see here there is a principle.
Para ser praticado diante de Deus.
To be done before God.
Honrar a Deus com tudo aquilo que nós temos.
To honor God with all that we have.
Ele viveu riquezas do Senhor.
He lived the riches of God.
E ele honrou ao Senhor com tudo que ele tinha.
And he honored the Lord with everything that he had.
E ele nos trouxe esse conselho para nós honrarmos a Deus com tudo aquilo que nós temos.
And he brought this advice for us so we can honor the Lord with all that we have.
E ele fala da consequência de quando nós fazemos isso.
And he speaks of the results or consequences of when we do this.
Quando alguém honra o Senhor com todos os seus bens,
when somebody comes and honors the Lord with all his possessions.
O versículo 10 deixa claro qual é a consequência.
The verse 10 makes it very clear what it is the consequence.
Se encherão com fartura os teus celeiros.
Your barns will be filled.
E transbordarão de vinho os teus reservatórios.
And they will overflow with new wine.
A palavra celeiros e a palavra reservatórios.
The words barns and the vats.
Elas simplesmente representam.
They represent.
O que era utilizado como um meio de armazenamento deles naquela época.
What they used to keep what they had at that time.
Pode ser que se você não mora em um local rural.
Perhaps when you if you do not live in the countryside, for an example.
Você não armazene seu mantimento, suas coisas em celeiros e em reservatórios.
You perhaps don't keep your food or what you need day-to-day life in barns, for an example.
Para guardar, para armazenar vinho.
To keep the wine.
Ou mantimentos e coisas parecidas.
Or the food like groceries.
Normalmente nós temos armários.
We normally have the cupboards.
E outros tipos de locais para armazenar as coisas que nós recebemos, o que nós compramos.
And other things we use to keep what we buy, what we shop for
então,
food.
Isso é só para equalizar o nosso entendimento.
This is just for us to equalize our understanding.
Mas o principal aqui é a gente entender o seguinte.
But the main bit here is for us to know this thing.
Que nós precisamos seguir esses princípios da palavra de Deus.
That we need to follow these principles of the word of God.
E quando você segue esse princípio de honra,
and when you follow this principle of honor,
os seus celeiros vão transbordar,
your barns will overflow,
vai haver fartura,
will be plenty.
Os seus reservatórios também estarão sempre cheios.
They will always be filled also.
Isso fala de prosperidade, isso fala de abundância.
This speaks of prosperity and abundance.
É claro que nós não precisamos de abundância somente na vida financeira.
Of course we do not need abundance only when we speak of financial life.
Mas nós também precisamos na vida financeira.
But we also need meaning financial life.
E a palavra aqui está dizendo exatamente disso.
And the word here is speaking exactly about this.
De você, de nós vivermos a abundância de Deus.
For us to live the abundance of God.
Dentro do nosso lar.
Inside of our household.
De ter a provisão suficiente de Deus para a nossa vida.
To have enough provision of God in our lives.
Mas um princípio precisa ser seguido.
But one principle needs to be followed.
E esse princípio é a honra.
And this principle is the honor.
É importante a gente ter isso muito bem claro no nosso coração.
It is important for us to have this very clear inside of our hearts.
Quando você oferta e traz o seu dízimo na igreja,
when you bring the offer and the tithes to the church,
você não está tendo uma atitude qualquer.
It's not like you doing so and so thing, anything.
Você não está simplesmente dando o seu dinheiro para a igreja.
You're not simply giving your money to church.
Mas a palavra deixa muito claro aqui.
But the word makes it very clear here.
Que você está honrando a Deus com aquilo que você possui.
That you're honoring God with what you have.
E nós vemos na palavra de Deus.
And we see here in the word of God.
Que sempre que alguém honra o Senhor,
Anytime somebody is honoring the Lord,
Deus também honra essas pessoas.
God is also honoring these people.
Então, se nós temos um princípio de honra no nosso coração,
so if we have the principle of honor inside of our hearts,
você pode ter certeza absoluta,
you can be sure of,
de que Deus também vai honrar a sua vida.
God is also honor your life.
Trazendo provisão em tudo aquilo que você precisa.
Bringing provision in everything that you need.
Manifestando abundância na sua vida.
Manifesting abundance in your life.
Não importa a situação que você está vivendo nesse momento.
It doesn't matter the situation you live in this moment.
Ela não fala mais alto do que a palavra de Deus.
It doesn't speak louder than the word of God.
A palavra de Deus está acima das circunstâncias.
The word of God is above all of circumstances.
Eu particularmente,
me myself,
tenho passado desafios nas finanças.
I'm facing challenges inside my financial life.
Mas esses desafios,
but these challenges,
não impedem de eu estar aqui falando o que a palavra de Deus diz.
They don't stop me coming here and speak of what of the word of God says.
Esses desafios que eu tenho passado,
these challenges I am facing,
eles não falam mais alto do que a palavra de Deus na minha vida.
They are not louder than the word of God in my life.
E se você também tem passado desafios,
and if you are facing challenges,
coloque a palavra de Deus acima deles.
Put the word of God above them all.
E você vai viver a abundância de Deus.
And you're going to experience, you're going to live.
Deus vai trazer prosperidade e abundância sobre a sua vida.
God is going to bring provision and prosperity upon your life.
Mas o princípio de honra tem que estar muito bem claro dentro do nosso coração.
But the principle of honor, it must be very clear inside of our hearts.
Eu honro a Deus com tudo aquilo que eu tenho.
I honor God with everything that I have.
Independente se ele vai me beneficiar com isso ou não.
No matter the benefits, if I have the benefits or not.
Eu faço por obediência.
I do it in obedience.
Porque eu entendo que como um filho de Deus,
because I understand that as a son of God,
eu preciso agradar o coração do meu pai.
I need to please the heart of my father.
Isso que nós precisamos entender.
This is what we need to understand.
E a palavra de Deus, ela vai se cumprir.
And the word of God is going to come to pass.
A cada dia ela vai se cumprir na sua vida.
Each day is going to come and to pass in your life.
Pode ser que você seja um imigrante nessa nação.
Perhaps you are one immigrant in this land.
Ou mesmo tenha nascido nessa nação.
Or you born in this nation.
Isso não importa.
It doesn't matter.
Nessa situação.
In this situation.
Deus ele não vai privilegiar alguns porque nasceram aqui.
God is not going to bring privilege to the ones who were born in here.
Ou de alguma forma privilegiar outros.
Or somehow bringing privilege to others.
Que estão como imigrantes.
They are here as immigrants.
Não, o princípio é a palavra de Deus.
No, the principle is the word of God.
Você pode ser abençoado como imigrante.
You can be blessed as an immigrant.
Ou você pode ser abençoado como um nativo.
Or you can be blessed as a native.
Não há restrições de viver a bênção de Deus.
There are not restrictions when it comes to live the blessings of God.
De acordo com o local que você nasceu.
According to the place where you were born.
Mas a bênção de Deus vem sobre a sua vida.
But the blessing of the Lord comes upon your life.
De acordo com o que você honra a palavra de Deus.
According to the way you honor the word of God.
Então, se você é um imigrante.
So if you are an immigrant.
E honra a palavra de Deus.
And you honor the word of God.
Os princípios da palavra de Deus.
The principles of the word of God.
Você pode viver tão bem.
You can live so well.
Quanto alguém que nasceu nessa própria nação.
As someone who was born in this nation.
Melhor.
Even better.
Porque Deus é aquele que traz a bênção e a provisão na nossa vida.
Because God is the one who brings the blessing and the provision to our lives.
Eu creio de todo o meu coração.
I believe with all of my heart.
Que nós vamos viver tempos abundantes.
That we are going to live abundant times.
Mais e mais.
More and more.
Você, a sua família,
you and your family,
nós como igreja,
we as a church,
esteja preparado,
be ready,
cumprindo princípios da palavra de Deus,
fulfilling the principles of the word of God,
sendo obediente ao conhecimento que chega para você,
being obedient to the knowledge that comes to you,
porque eu tenho certeza absoluta no meu coração.
Because I am pretty sure in my heart.
Vai se manifestar abundância.
The abundance is going to be manifested.
Mais e mais sobre a sua vida.
Abundance more and more upon your life.
Sobre a sua família.
Upon your family.
Sobre os seus negócios.
Your business.
Sobre o seu trabalho.
Your work.
A honra do Senhor.
The honor of God.
Vai se manifestar na sua vida.
Is going to be manifested in your life.
Deus, ele tem algo preparado para nós como igreja.
God has something prepared for us as church.
Ele tem uma medida de abundância muito grande para nós como igreja também.
He's got such a measure of abundance for us as church.
Porque nós temos um propósito como igreja.
Because we have a purpose as church.
De expandir, de levar a palavra.
To expand and to take the word.
De implantar novas igrejas.
To plant more churches.
De alcançar mais pessoas.
To reach more people.
E para tudo isso, querendo ou não,
and for all of this, like it or not,
é necessário boas condições financeiras para fazer.
We need good conditions, financial conditions is needed.
E essas condições vão ser abundantes em nós como igreja.
And these conditions, they are going to be abundant in us as church.
Em nome de Jesus.
In Jesus' name.
Em nome de Jesus.
In Jesus' name.
Eu creio sobre abundância.
I believe abundance.
Vindo sobre nós.
Coming upon our lives.
Porque é Deus quem vai realizar.
Because it's God who's going to do so.
Não sou eu.
It's not me.
Não é somente a minha palavra.
Not only my word.
Mas é a palavra de Deus.
But the word of God.
Que é verdadeira sobre a nossa vida.
Who is true upon our lives.
Nós vamos viver dias abundantes.
We are going to live
mais
abundant
mais
days.
Abundantes.
More and more abundant.
Mais do que você já viveu em qualquer época da sua vida.
More than you ever lived in your
vai
life.
Vai vir sobre a sua vida.
Is gonna come upon your life in the name of Jesus Christ.
Com a permissão do nosso pastor.
If my pastor allows me.
Eu quero que você vamos mudar um pouco, vamos fazer uma oração antes de ofertar nesse momento.
Let us change a little bit. Let us pray a little prayer before we bring.
Então se você puder se coloque em pé.
So if you can stand on your feet.
Aleluia.
Aleluia.
Se você vai ofertar, trazer, entregar o seu dízimo nessa manhã.
If you offer and you bring in your tithes this morning.
Ou não vai fazer.
Or if not.
Mas eu quero que você pegue o seu envelope.
I want you to grab one of the envelopes.
Levante comigo.
Lift it up with me. Raise it in your hands.
Amém.
Amen.
Pai, nós te agradecemos.
Father, we thank you.
Por esse tempo aqui reunidos.
For this time here that we gathered together.
Para te louvar, para te adorar.
To worship and adore you.
Para entregar aquilo que nós temos.
To give you all we have.
Para derramar o nosso coração diante do Senhor.
To lay our hearts before you.
E Pai, nesse momento nós podemos.
Father, this time we can.
Entregar os nossos dízimos.
Give you
ofertas.
Our tithes and offerings.
Nós queremos fazer isso. Pai.
And we want to do this, Father.
Obedecendo um princípio de honra ao Senhor.
Obeying a principle of honor to you.
Simplesmente em obediência ao Senhor.
Simply in obedience to you.
Honrando o Senhor.
Honoring you.
Porque o Senhor fez tanto por nós.
Because you have done so much for us.
Isso é algo que nós podemos retribuir de alguma forma.
This is something that we can bring back to you somehow.
Como obediência ao Senhor.
As obedience to you.
Pai,
Father,
a tua bênção,
your blessing,
a tua provisão,
your provision,
alcançando,
reaching,
se manifestando em cada vida nesse lugar,
manifesting in every single life in this place,
em cada família representada aqui,
each family that is represented here,
em nome de Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
tudo aquilo que é contrário à tua palavra,
everything that comes opposite to your word,
tudo aquilo que vem como miséria,
everything that comes like miseries,
nós repreendemos no nome de Jesus Cristo.
We rebuke in the name of Jesus Christ.
E declaramos a tua abundância.
We declare your abundance.
Declaramos a tua provisão.
We declare your provision.
Nas nossas vidas.
In our lives.
Em nome de Jesus
Cristo. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Provisão financeira chegando.
Financial provision.
nation coming.
O Senhor conhece cada coração aqui.
You know every single heart here.
O Senhor sabe que muitas pessoas, Pai, têm desejo de contribuir.
You know so many people here, they desire to bring more.
Mas muitas vezes,
but for so many times,
não têm encontrado condições.
They cannot find conditions to do so.
Mas o Senhor não se preocupa com a quantidade.
But you're not worried about the amount.
O Senhor se preocupa com o princípio que está no nosso coração.
You care about the principles that you can find in our hearts.
É isso que o Senhor observa.
This is what you observe.
Então, Pai,
so, Father,
o princípio de honra que nós estamos, que nós temos em nosso coração.
See the principle of honor that we have in our hearts.
E vamos cumprir a cada dia.
And we're going to do this each day, honoring you.
Em nome de Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Nós vamos viver o melhor do Senhor.
We are going to live the best of the Lord.
O Senhor tem abundância para nós.
The Lord has abundance for us.
Provisão para as nossas vidas.
Provision to our lives.
Nós não seremos envergonhados.
We'll not be ashamed.
Em nenhuma situação.
In any situation.
O mundo não vai olhar para as nossas vidas.
The world won't look to our lives.
Como pessoas necessitadas.
As people in need.
Mas eles vão olhar para nós.
But they will look at us.
E ver que o Senhor existe.
And see that you exist.
E vão glorificar o teu nome.
And they will glorify your name.
Através das nossas vidas.
Through our lives.
Através daquilo que vem.
Through what they see.
O Senhor fazendo nas nossas vidas.
You're doing in our lives.
Em nome de Jesus.
In the name of
Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Aleluia.
Aleluia.
Amém. Provisão e abundância de Deus sobre a sua vida mais e mais.
Provision and abundance upon your life more and more.
Honre ao Senhor.
Honor the Lord.
O Senhor vai nos honrar.
And the Lord will honor
a cada
us.
Cada dia.
Every day.
Em nome de Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Aleluia.
Aleluia.
Nós temos na tela os dados da conta bancária.
We have the details on our screen if you desire to give online.
Se você desejar, você pode fazer transferência. Ou também entregar um papel moeda nesse momento.
Or if you wish to bring some cash, you have the envelopes on your chairs.
Deus os abençoe.
May God bless you.
Na prática da palavra de Deus.
And the doing of the word of
Amém.
God. Amen.
Hallelujah. God is good. All the time He is good. Amen. Hallelujah. Grace and peace of the Lord God multiply in your life. This is the day that the Lord has made for you. Great things is coming for you today. I know that the Lord has much more for us this morning. Are you ready to receive everything? Be ready. Because the Lord God loves your life. And miracles and wonder will be released today. If you don't believe, I will believe for you. Ha! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! This morning, the Lord gave a direction for me. And I want to invite you to greet your neighbor, give a hug, and we will start the service. Hallelujah. 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 It's good to see Senira here. Welcome, Senira. It's your house. We love you. Senira is our friend for many, many years. Hallelujah. Are you ready for what the Lord has for you today? Yes. Stand your feet and find one person. We will start this message in powerful. Maria, can you come here, please? Hallelujah. The Lord put something in my heart this morning. And be aware. Be connected in the Word. Because great things will happen today. We will start this service with a confession. Look, did you choose your neighbor? Choose someone, please. Hallelujah. Stay in front of your neighbor. Look, you will declare in their life, in she or his lives. I will give an example. If you were receiving the declaration, you don't say nothing. Just hear what the Lord has for you. You will see you are loved by God. You are beautiful. You are power in the kingdom of the heaven. God bring you to change this generation. You have much more. Ah, God has a lot of things for your life, Maria. You are different. Ha ha. You start to declare. Hallelujah. You have power. I love you. Thank you for everything that you are doing for me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is good. Oh, remember what I said last month? You carry the presence of God inside. You are the ark of the new covenant. When you arrive, there is power to deliver people, to save lives, to transform, and the Lord count on you. Hallelujah. In the Old Testament, the presence of the Lord was upon. Now is inside of you. But He wants to move through you. You are the answer for this generation. These people next to you need something. And you have it. Don't be quiet. But rise in power. Because the Lord will move through your life. Start to see how the Lord see you. Great. Bigger. You are sons and daughter. You are not more slave. The Bible say that you can sit in the table and eat with your father. He is your father. The word says that you are ambassador, the presence of God. When you arrive in some place, miracles will happen because you represent the kingdom of God. It is not in the strength of your arm, but it's by the presence of the Lord. The Lord was telling me this week, tell it for them. They need to recognize who they are. There is a verse in the Bible in Proverbs chapter 27, verse 3. For as you think you are in your heart, so you are. Like you see yourself, you are. Start to see yourself bigger. You are queens. You are kings. You are the best of your father. You are loved. You are strong. You have everything that you need for this season. I don't know how you enter in this place, but I know how you live from here. Yes. Hallelujah. Receive by faith. We are people of faith. Yes. You carry it. When the devil see for you, he tremble. Because you are different. You carry things. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How great is our God. Circumstance. You will face my God this morning. No limitation. No limitation will stop you today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In Psalms chapter 2 verse 4 says that the Lord God is seated in his throne, mocking from his enemies. You are the son. You can mock your enemies already. It's very amazing this, because God is mocking his enemies. But God is not in the time that we are living now. He is in the Kairos. We are in the Chronos. We live morning, afternoon, and evenings. But the Lord God lives in Kairos. He knows that the devil already is judged. Your problems is done in him. It's powerful. Yes. He doesn't have enemies because he sits upon everything. Hallelujah. It's powerful. Hallelujah. We have the Zoe. The Zoe in Greek means the life of God. You have the breath of God inside of you. When you speak, you release the life of God. Look, when I breathe, when you pray for someone, or when you declare in people's life, the power of God that is inside of you, transform these people, change situation, because it's not you, it's the power of God living from your mouth. Yes. Hallelujah. It's powerful. If you realize it and put in your heart, you will mark this generation. God count on you. We are not the same. We have limitation, but we have the same spirit. Amen. The Lord wants to do new things among us, but in unity. It's not a competition. It's not about the performance. I don't care about it. What I want is reach people, because the most things that the Lord God loves is people. Hallelujah. Start to love people. Start to pray for people, for your friends, for your children, for your parents. Hallelujah. I know the Spirit has changed my message, but don't worry. I am led by the Spirit. Hallelujah. Someone needs to hear this morning. Don't worry if you don't speak English properly. One word from the Lord can change lives. Yes. Can save families. Yes. Oh, hallelujah. 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 Say with me. Faith works when I say what I believe. And I believe in the Word of God. This Word is the final authority in my life. Hallelujah. Oh, it's powerful. Let me say something. When I went to the ministry school in Campina Grande, I did discover for my Bible. And the guy said, what do you have in the cover? I said, put faith, put my name. But let me know, let me say something for you. Just faith here will not change nothing. But when the faith is in my heart and come out of my mouth, it will change the situation. Amen. Hallelujah. Your God is great. And you are as well. Hallelujah. Do you know our mission, vision, and values of the Word of Life? Do you know? Who know? Look, I will put here. They put, okay, it's fine. Do you know? Someone know? Amen. Well done, Samira. Can you put here, Pastor, for us, please? We will speak about faith. We are people of faith, amen? Look at the vision of our ministry. Mission, vision, and values. Mission, let's say together. Vision. Values. Hallelujah. Our ministry is built on faith. You can see everywhere there is the word faith. Hallelujah. What is faith for you? Help me. What is faith for you? Help me. What is faith for you? Wow. Well done. What you said, sir? Wow. Anyone more? Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen, Glaucia. Well done. Yes. Wow. Amen. Wow, you are prepared, guys. Well done. For me, it's a lifestyle. Faith must be my way of life. It must be present 24/7 in my life, in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening. For many years ago, my father is pastor from another church, but I thought that I have to use the faith when I face problems. But no, it is a lifestyle. Every moment of my life, I walk in faith. Amen. Every moment, every morning, every afternoon. Hallelujah. This is the theme of the month. Faith. Maria spoke very good about the spirit of fear and the spirit of faith to overcome problems in life. Pastor Jordel then laid a foundation on what faith is. He said about the word, Greek word pistis, that mean full conviction. And in the Bible, we can see many heroes of faith. And I brought one. I don't know if you know Smith Wigglesworth, the apostle of faith. This is the book of the month. If you didn't have the opportunity to read, please do. It will edify your heart, your spirit, your soul. Amen? And I got a passage here from this book that is very nice. And I want to share with you. Smith Wigglesworth, the great British preacher, he said, "I never consider myself fully dressed until I put my Bible in my pocket and in my heart. It would be easier for me to go out without shoes than without the scriptures." Smith Wigglesworth, after every meal, even in restaurants, he would always move a little way from the table, pick up the Bible, and say, "We have fed the body. Now let's feed the inner man." Then Smith Wigglesworth would read something about faith and usually end up giving a short message. Smith said, "Faith is an act." That's what faith is, acting on the word of God. Hallelujah. One occasion, someone asked for another man of God, Raymond Richelieu, a man powerfully used by God in the ministry of divine healing in times gone by. "What is faith?" Richard replied, "Faith is simply putting the word of God in practice." Wow! Faith is like a Wi-Fi. It's invisible, but it has the power to connect you to what you need. There is Wi-Fi here that is producing, putting life. It's the faith. You can see the faith, but it's operating in your favor. Amen. Hallelujah. Someone say for me, faith doesn't. We need to believe in your heart and confess with our mouth. Amen. For your faith works, you need to walk in love. There is some enemies of faith. They are unbelief, unforgiveness, and lack of love. Never forget to walk in love with people. You can forgive others because you have the Lord inside of you. Love is a decision. If you have to, in this day, if you have to forgive someone, do. Take your phone, call this person and ask, "I love you and I forgive you." Put in your heart. People just give for you what they have. If they gave something that you don't like, don't worry. That's what they have. You have the love of God inside of you. You have the decision to love these people. Sometimes if you don't forgive people, things is hindered in your life. Release it. and run the race that the Lord prepared for your life. Things that you are in it to come out. Hallelujah. I don't know why I say it, but I know the Holy Spirit is here, and He will minister in your heart this morning. Hey, the key of your victory is love, is forgiveness. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, because you are good. Love works, faith works in our faith. Hallelujah. Everyone in this place, in this room, has faith. Hallelujah. This morning I want to speak about the woman with the issue of blood. Hallelujah. Let's open our Bibles in Mark chapter 5. I will start in the verse 24. Are you receiving something? It is because God loves you. He loves you so much. He has a great plan for your life, for your family. Great things is coming. I will start in the 24, but I want to say something in the verse 21. If you see the history began with Jairus' daughter, but the woman with the issue of blood got in the way. If you cross the way of Jesus, you will not be the same. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's read together from the verse 24. Please help me involve in this service, because the Lord wants to use your life. Amen. So Jesus went with him, and a great multitude followed him and trod him. Can you put in the New Living Translation, please? Can you read? Someone can read for me, please, to understand better and for you participate in the service. Rui, can you read for me? 25, please. Until 34. Hallelujah, how powerful. Rui, you are powerful. You are a minister of the gospel. God will use you a lot. Go out the comfort zone. People exclaim for your life. There is anointing in your voice. Hallelujah. The steps we learn from this passage are easy. They are 1, hear; 2, release; 3, declare; 4, receive; and 5, tell. I will start the step one in the verse 27, part A of the verse. She heard that Jesus was there. The word says that faith comes by hearing, and hearing the word of God. But unbelief comes by hearing as well. We need to stay in the word, hearing the right things. Amen. Faith doesn't come by prayer. Faith doesn't come by fasting. Faith doesn't come through church time. Amen. But now, what is your association? Your association is change. Your belief in your faith. If you are walking with person that just speak unbelief, leave this person. Just but don't leave your partner or family. Eh? I am watching you. If you didn't spend time recruiting, now you will spend time teaching and teaching your partner. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is good. Our association is very important to us. And I want to honor my wife here, because for a time, I spoke some unbelief, because when I arrived in this church, for many Sundays, I left from here very frustrated. I know some preach doesn't speak the process, just the result, but I will speak for you the process, because it will change your life. And for many Sundays, I came in this church, and I came to my house very frustrated, because I had some words in my life that I knew that changed lives, but I didn't have a English to speak or transmit what I have. But always when I speak unbelief, my wife said, "Do you want that I agree with you?" And immediately I recognize, no, love, don't agree with it. But you need to stand with the right persons near you. Choose your friendship, because it will change your life. Oh, hallelujah. My mom used to say, "Tell me who you work with, and I will tell you who you are." It's the truth. One key that I want to teach you: ask question to yourself. Why I am speaking? Why I am believing this friendship is bring me for another level, or it is hold me to live what the Lord God has for my life? Make a question for you. Open your Bible. Find what the Bible says. Hallelujah. Step 2, release. In the verse 27, part B, so she came up behind him, threw the crown, and touched the robe. We can learn here that the faith has an action. It's not enough just believe and confess, but I need to have an action correspondent what I am believing. Amen. Put the word in practice. Wow, I studied about the woman of issue of blood, and by law she couldn't be there. She had to be isolated in quarantine. She could have been stoned and died. But her faith was great. And the Bible say, all things are possible to who believes in the word. Hallelujah. The Bible says that in Galatians chapter 3 verse 11, the just shall live by faith. You live by faith. You don't live by sight. Stopping to declare what are you seeing and start to declare what you want to see in your life, in your family, in your children, in your work. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Wow. Step 3. Declare means to speak, confess. The definition of confession, guys, to speak the same things, to declare, to consent, to agree. We need to speak the right things. Hallelujah. I studied about 8% of the population of the world have the same thoughts. We have 25,000 thoughts per day. But we need the importance, what we have to renew our mind with the word of God. Many people do many terrible things because they don't control their thoughts. That's why we need to renew our mind every day, every moment. Because the faith comes by hearing. If you are hearing bad news on TV, it will transform you. Ha! It will put you down. Santa, long time ago, I used to watch the TV in Brazil. But wow, I saw many bad things. Ah, someone died here. Wow, turn off it. And connect with the word of God. It's the truth. This is the truth. If you read it, it is the new for tomorrow. It is, you have everything that you need here. If the people say, you can do, you say, the word says that I can do all things in Christ that strengthens me. You can it. Because the word tries to say what you are not. You are what your father says you are. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Look what this woman said in the verse 28. If I can just touch in his robe, I will be healed. She was speaking positive things. If you don't have nothing positive to say, don't say nothing. Because you are creating things in the spiritual world and you are bringing for the reality, for the natural. Wow. Imagine she saying, there is no way. All the best docs have given up on my case. I will die. We need to leave the Vietnamese zone. And you have to see like your father see you. Stopping to say what you are seeing. Hallelujah. God is good. He has a plan. And the faith has a voice. Faith is a spirit. Fear is a spirit. But we are people of faith. We declare. We bring life for others. We walk in joy, in peace. We make difference in this generation, in this city, in your work. Everywhere you go, you will do the difference. Did you see when people say, you have something different? It's because God is living you. But He wants to live in you, but He wants to magnify His glory through you. For this time, we are living the last day of the church in this earth. And many people are dying because I am with my mouth shut. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Law of faith, believing and speaking. There is the mental faith. This is not our faith. Our faith is from the heart. Because we believe in our heart and confess with our mouth. Amen. Romans 1 chapter 70 says, my righteousness one will live by faith. When I go to Genesis chapter 1, I can see He created everything through the word speaking. And I brought something for you. Can you put the video now, Pastor Jordel? Hallelujah. God is good. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Something like that. But in reality, you're rather.
Let me read here between the, you will put the video. I will read in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 3. By faith, we understand that the words were framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of things which are visible. Hallelujah. Can you put, Pastor Jordel? Hallelujah.
If you look up an image of the earth and moon,
can you
put a picture where they're quite close together? Something like that. But in reality, the Earth and Moon are about that far apart. That is the Earth and the Moon to scale. Taking the same concept, but for the solar system,
can you put in front
every single picture of the solar system that we ever encounter is not to scale. If you put the orbits to scale on a piece of paper, the planets become microscopic, and you won't be able to see them. Is literally not an image that adequately shows you what it actually looks like from out there. The only way to see a scale model of the solar system is to build one.
Welcome to Black Rock Desert.
Put forward the video. A little bit forward. Yes, now.
This is Alex. I'm right. Wiley.
Sorry,
he's
guys.
Gonna be behind the camera. I'm going to be.
I don't know.
A lot of mistakes on camera. We have 36 hours to measure the distances, trace out the orbits, and set up a time lapse shot from up. Venus is the same size as Earth.
Sorry, Pastor, it's not this video. Sorry. Yeah. But you can put the other one. Do you have the one that I sent to you? It's not this one. Yeah, okay. Hallelujah. Yes, this one is other one.
Dr. Emoto has conducted another interesting experiment. He placed rice into three glass beakers and covered it with water. And then every day for a month, he said, Thank you to one beaker. You're an idiot to the second. And the third one, he completely ignored. After 1 month, the rice that had been thanked began to ferment, giving off a strong, pleasant aroma. The rice in the second beaker turned black. And the rice that was ignored began to rot. Dr. Emoto thinks that this experiment provides an important lesson, especially with regard to how we treat children. We should take care of them, give them attention, and converse with them. Indifference does the greatest harm.
Dreamy story, but almost. But
you can see the power of the words. The word can bring life, but death as well. You have to be careful about what you are saying for your children, for your husband, for your family, because it's producing things in the spiritual world. The faith is, I like to say it, faith is an arm that brings things from the spiritual world for the natural world. The Bible says, your mouth, there is a power of death and life. But if you like to speak death, it will be in your life. But if you say life, people will be benefit from your mouth. Amen. I had another video, but God is good. Hallelujah. Step four, receive. You have to be ready to receive from God. Verse 29. Immediately, the bleeding stopped, and she could feel in her body that she had been healed of her terrible condition. Verse 30. Jesus realized at once that healing power had gone out from him. So he turned around in the crowd and asked, "Who touched my robe?" Here, the faith asks for action. She took the robe of God and she was healed. That woman faith made the power flow from Jesus into her. With our faith, we can connect to God's power. It's present here, everywhere. So put that power into action for our own good. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Step five, tell. Verse 33. Can you read together this verse? Yes, to conclude. No problem, Sim. Thank you for your help. Yes. Let's go. One, two, three. Hallelujah. Faith will propel us to share the gospel, to share out testimony, to build up others. Your testimony can change lives. Your testimony can heal people in the mind, in the body. Amen. Amen. Do you believe it? If you receive something from God, have gratitude in your heart. Share with others what the Lord is doing in your life. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ha, I brought something for you today. Mustard seeds. Who knows what is the connection between faith and a mustard seed? Small. The word says if you have a faith like a mustard seed, you can move mountains. Hallelujah. Many things the Lord will do through you. Hallelujah. Because He is not looking about your faith if it is bigger or short or small. Hallelujah. Can you give a microphone for Maria, please? I will give for you the seed, because every time when you see the seed, you will see that you have a faith inside of you that can change people, can change your situation. Amen?
Hallelujah. I was going to explain about the seed, but He has already done it. Maybe it's not obvious, but this is a magnet. You can put it on your fridge. You can put it anywhere with metal, but your fridge would be amazing. That's a mustard seed, and every time you look at that seed, you remember that if you have faith as small as a mustard seed, but if you put it into practice, you can move mountains. So every time you look at the mustard seed, just say, I have faith, I can move mountains. Amen. Amen. Hallelujahs. Yeah. Amen, amen. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is good. Stand to your feet. Hallelujah. I know that the Lord has something for you. Close your eyes, and now we will visualize by faith something in your life. Hallelujah. Start now. You can increase the sound, please, a little bit. Close your eyes. And start imagining you are a seed. The seed will be planted in the ground. Now get down to the floor like that. Hallelujah. Can you go to the ground, please? Hallelujah. Connect with the word. Hallelujah. I know that the Lord has something for you. Hallelujah. Now imagine the rain of the Spirit watering the seed. You are the seed. Hallelujah. You will germinate. Hallelujah. Will grow strong. Let's get up slowly. Get up slowly. Stretch your arms now and close your eyes. Imagine. They are the branches. Ha ha. Ha ha. And you produce fruits now. Your life is producing fruits for others. Ha, fruits for your family. Fruits for your friends. Hallelujah. Fruits of compassion. Fruits of love. Fruits of goodness, fruits of faith. By faith, see people eating the fruits that you have. Hallelujah, people eating and be feeding by the gift that you have in your heart, in your life. This is the plan of God. You are a tree for this generation. You are a tree for this church. Hallelujah. Start to see you bigger, bigger, bigger. You have seeds. You have fruits on you. You have a river inside of you that people want to drink. Thank you, Father, for new gifts now. Releasing things this morning, Lord. New gifts, new confidence. Thank you for discernment for this season. Hallelujah. I know, Lord, they will not be the same because your word came today and will change their lives this morning. Ha ha! Start to see what the Lord sees you. You are ambassador of the presence of the Lord. The Lord count on you for this time. This church needs you. Samira, let me say something for you. You are bigger in the Lord. Yes. Start to sing the songs. I know your heart that sometimes you say it's difficult to sing in English, but you have anointing to do it. You have anointing upon you. People need what you have, Samira. It will flow. It will be easy. If you trust in the Lord, He is your friend, He is your father, He is in your sight. Ha 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 ha. Woo. Sin, I have a word for you, Sin. Many weeks ago, the Lord put a word in my heart for you. Sometimes you think that you are just the mother of the pastor. Yes, you are. But you are the pillar of this church. God has a plan for your life. I can see many women going be rich by the anointing that is upon you, upon your life. You are not the one woman in the multitude. You are different. You care something different. Ha ha. There is a power. There is a power. Hallelujah. Just trust in the anointing. Look, I am here. If I see in the natural, I can't be here. But it's about the anointing. The anointing will do everything that you need. I know the Lord spoke it in your heart. It is just the confirmation that you have inside. Start to meditate in the word. Start to put these hands in the other people. And you will see the miracles. You will see cancer leave going. Hey, if you see like God see you, sin. It's not about Pastor Jordel. It's about the calling that he called you to do. Ha ha. Don't say no. Answer yes. Ha ha. Ha ha. Start to pray in tongues. Ra vranderere vrandelehe. Sekelala manalala shererere kandala ya seke. Robondo nororo selelelele nanakandara shererere kandara. If you feel something inside of you, go. And put lay the hands upon your neighbors. Please, you are ambassador of the presence. You carry the different things. Let God move through your life. You are the answer for others. Ha 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 ha. Ha ha. Ha ha. Ha Aleluia. Franele e ha se querere. Ho ho ho. Ha ha. Hey, hey, I am prepared, Lord, for you. Thank you, Lord, for your presence in this place. Thank you, Lord, because the seed that you plant in my brothers and sisters' life today will give fruits 100 per one, and they will impact this generation. Thank you for your love. That's I receive from them, and they are received from you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Guys, be blessed in the practice of the Word of God. Amen. Amen. I love you. And never forget, you are a bless. You are a champion. You have many things inside of you.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Pastor Manasseh. Thank you, sir. Hallelujah. You know, guys, we're at this weekend, we're at our annual senior leaders prayer retreat. And the word the Lord has given us for this weekend has been a scripture from 2 Corinthians. And it says that eye has not seen and ear has not heard, nor entered into the heart of man the things the Lord has prepared for them that love him and are, you know, called. But our confession has been that what our eye has not seen or what our ear has not heard shall enter our hearts this weekend. We may not see it with our natural eyes. We may not. In fact, we've never seen it. You've never experienced it. You've never touched it. You've never listened to it just yet. But those things the Lord are releasing. Amen. And you know what, guys? The anointing flows from the head and flows through. Amen. The power and the anointing, the authority starts at the head of the church, the Lord Jesus Christ. And as we submit to his ways and submit to his words, that power flows through. Amen. So if God has given the senior leadership this word, it flows through the church. Amen. So to practice this word that Pastor Manna says has brought to us this week, begin declaring, Lord, what my eyes have not seen, what my ears have not heard, I receive by faith in my heart. And then, guys, you begin to speak that out. You begin to speak that out. Amen. I loved what he said, because God is not in our timing. God is in the heavenly realms. He sees the end from the beginning. So in the place of prayer, sometimes we're praying from earth and we just see all the circumstances around us. So God is saying, pray from my perspective. Amen. Come up from the heavenly realms where you already sit and see from my perspective. Because sometimes you just see the mountain, you see the wall. But when you go up and say, Father, what is your plan? What is your will concerning this? He says, hey, this is what I'm showing you. This is what will happen. So you come back to this earthly realm and you begin to declare, not what you see of your natural eyes, but you agree with heaven. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Pastor Manna says. Powerful word. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Let's just run for our announcements quick. So, guys, this Tuesday at 9 p.m., we have our online prayer meeting. We always start with a word. You know, guys, one of the main reasons people don't always pray that much or their prayers are not as effective is because they don't understand what the Bible says about prayer. So every week online, we receive a word and then we pray together as the church. You are the church, amen. So come and join us. On Sunday, our services starts at 10:45 with prayer in this room. We are still going through our Bible reading plan, One Story That Leads to Jesus. So covering the Bible this year together as a church. This week, we are reading Job 16 to 39. And then Psalms 139, to 145. Our book of the month for this month is Ever Increasing Faith by Smith Wigglesworth. This book is also available on, I think, everywhere. Kindle. It's also available in Portuguese and Kindle. It's available on Spotify. It's available on YouTube. We have this book to sell as well. So guys, you have access.
Yes.
Go and grab it. Read it. Pull it in your spirit. Amen. Next Sunday, we'll have our communion service. And you also have the opportunity to bring food for the food bank. Amen. Guys, this Thursday, everyone say this Thursday, we have our Word of Life Bible School Taster class. Amen. And it's online at 7 p.m. via Zoom. I believe on the day, we'll share the Zoom link. Amen. But basically, yeah, it's going to be online Zoom from 7 p.m. The module is abundance. Okay. And here you're going to get a little taster of some of the classes. So next, is there another one? Yes. So we're going to have Pastor Gleason preaching on Bible prosperity. Amen. Edma Ray going to be teaching on the divine plan for family. Missionary Brother Getulio, fruit and holiness. And this handsome chap there. On Christian leadership, amen. Go on, Pastor Madison says I'm beautiful, right? I'm receiving that declaration, eh? I am. Anyway, so guys, this is an opportunity to get a taste of class of the Bible school. Obviously, this year it's going to be our third school that's going to be in English. And of course, if you speak Portuguese, or if you don't speak English, then the Portuguese school is also going to be available. Amen. But guys, let's be believing for a great class this year. Not only for us, but people across Europe. You know, we have people in other nations as well who are married to people that speak Portuguese or something else, but then the husband doesn't. So we're really believing for this class to be full this year. And I really encourage you guys. Amen. You know, doing a Bible school is not like you've done the Bible school and you're set for life. But the Bible school will give you an acceleration. Amen. You know, there's only so much we can cover on a Sunday service. And it's not even a full year. It's just about 10 months probably. But I really encourage you to do it. Amen. If you need any information, please speak to Maria. Amen. Cool. If it was your birthday or birthday or any anniversary this month, please come to the front. Anyone's birthdays? Do you get double blessed? Oh, get it too. That was your anniversary, wasn't it? Praise God. Anyone else? Oh, okay. All right then, guys. So, Ariane's, was it your birthday this month as well, right? Yes. Double month, double blessing. So, guys, let's pray, amen, for Alberto and Ariane. Father, we thank you, Lord. We celebrate Ariane's another year again, Lord, of her birthday. And also 9 years. Novas, yeah, yeah. Father, we thank you, Lord, for 9 years of blessed marriage. We celebrate, Father, and we thank you for this wonderful couple. We thank you, Lord, for the gift they are to us here in this church, Lord. And we thank you, Father, for you continually to prosper their marriage and their family, Lord, in Jesus' name. Father, fill them with wisdom and grace, Lord. Cause their increase and their influence to grow more and more in the name of Jesus. We thank you for their lives. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Well, guys, you know what time it is? You know, every month we have a generous family that offer some books for us to be blessed. Amen. So we're going to have our raffle time now. So everyone's got a raffle? I think I got mine there. Yeah, I do somewhere, but I always eliminate myself out. All right, here we go. First number is 257. 257? Okay, we've got some extra in the box. 261. Do we need to get lower? Zach, did you win? Oh, right, Zach. Oh, right, Zach. Man like Zach. Wait, Zach, Zach, get a picture. Yes, we've got a winner. Make some noise. Woo! Next up, what number have you got, Clay G? Where are you? 265. 249. Ah! Well done. Yes. Last and certainly not least, I don't think you prayed this morning, Clay G. Imagine. 270.
Yes!
Go on, Mia! Go on, Mia! Yo, yo, yo! Yes, Mia!
Who's
going to
read it?
Praise God. Well, guys, don't miss that next month, amen. Praise the Lord. Guys, don't forget to pick up your wonderful children. Look after them after the service as well. Amen. Have a blessed week.